that Leonard recently received a so-called Defender of the Faith Justice Award from a controversial fundamentalist preacher with a large following in Michigan. That preacher, Jack Hyles, has been accused of serious financial improprieties by some ex-followers who say he is a cult leader. Hyles, an independent Baptist pastor based in Hammond, Indiana, is regarded as a national leader for at least six churches in southeast Michigan, including the North Sharon Baptist Church, where Timothy Leonard is an associate pastor. TV2 investigator Vince Wade joins us with another special report called Praying from the Pulpit. Vince?
Thank you, Rich. You may not have heard of him, but thousands of ultra-conservative fundamentalists know who Jack Hyles is. He preaches that old-style religion, yet he rakes in money in the modern tradition of a Robert Tilton or Jim and Tammy Baker.
God for the Pope. He's against abortion. He's always been for getting all the Catholics he can get.
Brother Jack Hyles likes to boast he runs the largest Sunday school in the world. He may be right. Before a cloud of scandal drifted over his First Baptist Church of Hammond, Indiana, Hyles bragged he had a membership of 100,000. The Hyles empire is formidable. In addition to his church, he runs Hyles-Anderson Bible College in Schererville, Indiana. Anderson is Russell Anderson, a wealthy Ypsilanti land developer. He's reportedly donated millions of dollars to Hyles over the years. His secretary says he's been on an extended trip and not available for an interview about his relationship with Hyles. Most of Hyles' followers don't have Russell Anderson's deep pockets, but it's not uncommon for believers to donate 20% of their income to Brother Hyles.
The only person who knows where the money goes is Jack Hyles. He's said from the pulpit he spends the money that comes into his ministry any way he sees fit.
The deacon board at First Baptist of Hammond is described as a rubber stamp for Hyles.
They fear disagreeing with him because they fear that they're disagreeing with God.
Child support payments to Jack Hyles' former daughter-in-law, Paula Hyles, are an example of the preacher's questionable financial practices. When Hyles' son David fell behind on his payments, Paula began receiving payments from a church checking account. First Baptist of Hammond appears to be in violation of IRS rules for tax-exempt organizations. Bill Waddell is the police chief of Griffith, Indiana. He was a deacon in Hyles Church when the child support was paid with church funds.
Did you ever see these or hear about these monies being paid out?
No.
You think any of the other deacons did?
Not that I'm aware of.
And they've laid the foundation.
Hyles travels to cities all over America to preach and to accept offerings for his pulpit-pounding sermons. He advertises his appearances in fundamentalist newspapers. Hyles also sells video and audio tapes of his sermons. When you listen to them, you won't hear God or Jesus mentioned very often. Mostly, you hear Jack Hyles preaching about Jack Hyles. It all comes from Hyles' publications. No one seems to know if it's his private company or a church ministry.
Well, I cannot understand why the IRS hasn't gotten him, because of the fact that it's under the canopy of the church and all this money comes to him.
Jack Hyles doesn't live lavishly, unlike controversial televangelist Robert Tilton.
For him, money is a way to buy loyalty. He gives gifts to make people loyal to him.
Jenny Nischik Corle has received a lot of gifts from Hyles over the years, and she's intensely loyal to him. She's reputedly been Jack Hyles' mistress since 1969. Every Sunday, she sits on his left in the choir. Hyles' wife, Beverly, sits on the right. Jenny was the wife of Vic Nischik, who was a deacon in the church and used to be one of Hyles' close friends.
I knew for many years that there was an immoral sexual relationship between them.
Vic's home wasn't really his home. He was banished to the basement on Pastor Hyles' advice as a marriage counselor. In 1989, when the scandal surfaced publicly in a fundamentalist newspaper, here's what Hyles told the syndicated program, A Current Affair.
A fellow who would allow an outsider to send him to the basement would be a wimp.
When Vic Nischik objected to living in the basement, Hyles paid for a dormer to be built over the garage.
I would come home, I would find a new washer, dryer, and new furnace. Oh, he paid all the bills.
Hyles denied the affair, sort of.
I've had one woman in my life, John. One woman in my life. That's the mother of my children.
That's not the same as denying outright that he's ever had sex with Jenny Nischik. Voyle Glover, an Indiana attorney and former member of Hyles' congregation, totaled the money and gifts Hyles has admitted giving or loaning to Jenny Nischik. He says his conservative estimate exceeds $100,000.
Yeah, you don't give a woman you're not married to over $100,000 just because you're generous.
I consider myself as having been under total mind control of a religious fanatic, yes.
I believe in family. If I ever let my wife beside me, she don't know about my girlfriend or the man I met last night.
Last night, Jack Hyles told his congregation he's organizing a national protest against TV2 on June 1st. He's calling on 400 like-minded preachers to come to Detroit, where he claims he will hold a press conference to answer questions about his ministry. Four child molesting victims' rights groups have announced they intend to stage a counter-demonstration against Hyles and his followers. We've noted throughout these special reports that Jack Hyles has ignored our requests for an interview. Today, TV2 News Director Mort Meisner contacted Mr. Hyles, and he declined, once again, our invitation to respond to our story in an interview with me. We also asked Hyles to appear live on Straight Talk with Rich Fisher. Again, he declined. Hyles said, "I decline to be interviewed by your station. I don't trust your station. I will do interviews with other stations." News Director Meisner then thanked Jack Hyles and wished him the best of luck. Hyles told Meisner he wished Mort, quote, "the poorest of luck." Tomorrow night, the story of private eyes and dirty tricks aimed at children who dared to say they've been molested by so-called men of God. Rich?
Well, Vince, the invitation stands for an appearance on Straight Talk. Do you think he is really serious about doing interviews with other stations, other members of the media?
Well, he may. The key question for us is, if he comes to Detroit and he says he's going to hold a press conference, people that are watching this program tonight should pay attention to whether or not he meets with the reporters privately, or whether he decides to do this with a gallery of people going amen and right on preacher. Because if he does, then he's posturing and doesn't really want to answer the question. So that'll be the key. If he does show up here June 1st, people should be watching to see if he talks with us privately in a professional press conference setting.
Okay. Your final report tomorrow.
That's right.
All right. Thanks, sir.